chain, to break every chain, to break every chain.
Come on, somebody declare.
To break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain. There is power in the name of Jesus.
Come on, lift up those hands and declare.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power, there is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain.
Come on, somebody declare the power of the living God.
There is power in the name of Jesus. Yes.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Yeah. In the name of Jesus. To break every chain. Yeah.
Break every chain.
Break every chain.
Praise the name of the Lord. This is Choice Gospel Radio on 92.9 FM. Your life, your salvation, and your choice. Jesus is the answer. Make him your choice. On tonight. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This is Choice Gospel Radio on 92.9 FM. And tonight, we are listening to Salvation and Revelation, a program geared to bring you to the precious gift of salvation if you do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, and to unfold the mystery of the Word of God through the revelation of the Holy Spirit. Praise the name of the Lord. Shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before your mighty throne of grace and we say thank you for another opportunity where we can go into your word, O God. We say thank you, O God, Father, Lord God, for life and for health. We thank you for strength, O God. We say thank you for the air that we breathe, O God. We say thank you, O God, Father, Lord God, for every good and perfect gift come from you, O God. We thank you, O God, for all the things we take for granted, O God, for shelter, O God, for protection, O God. We say thank you, O God, for your mercy, O God. O God, it's new every morning, O God. We say thank you for your loving kindness upon our lives, O God. We praise you and we bless your name, O God. So many things, O God, that we forget to thank you for, O God. We thank you, O God, just for being in the land of the living, O God. So many have gone on to eternity, O God. And Father, Lord God, we have another opportunity whereby we can get it right with you, O God. So we thank you for the blessed gift of life, O God, for the air that we breathe, O God. We thank you, O God, for, O God, man is made of dust, but, O God, you breathe life into us, O God. So we thank you for that breath of life on tonight in the name of Jesus. We bless you, O God. We thank you. We invite your Holy Spirit to continue to dwell in this place, O God. We invite your Holy Spirit to take full control. O God, Father, Holy Spirit, the Father, God Almighty, send your power, O God, of your Spirit, O God, to, O God, rightly divide your word of truth, that everything that comes out of my mouth will be in accordance to your word, O God. Nothing missing, nothing lacking, in the name of Jesus. We ask your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of truth, to lead us, guide us, and direct us into all truth, that your people will be comforted, edified, and exhorted. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we welcome you, Holy Spirit, in this place. Not by might, not by power. Everything is done by the Spirit. And we say thank you, O God, for souls that will come into your kingdom on tonight. Thank you for lives that will be transformed and go to a higher place with you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Praise the name of the Lord.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus.
Praise the name of the Lord. The scripture reading tonight is taken from the book of Ephesians, reading from chapter 4, verse 1, and we're going to read verse 4, and then we go into all the way down to the 17th, 18th, and 19th chapter verses in that same chapter. Praise the name of the Lord. I always advise that if you have a pen and a paper, write the scripture down and go search the scripture yourself, because many false prophets and false teachers are gone out into the world, and if it's possible to deceive the very elect, amen. So you do not want to be deceived. Praise the name of the Lord. Ephesians chapter 4, which is speaking about the unity of the Spirit and the old and new life. Praise the name of the Lord. Reading from verse 1. It said, I therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, I beseech you that you walk worthy of the vocation which wherein ye are called, with all lowliness and meekness, with longsuffering, forbearing one another in love, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bonds of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, even as ye are called in one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in you all. But unto every one of us is given grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. Wherefore he saith, when he ascended up on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. Now that he ascended, what is it but all that he also descended first into the lower parts of the earth? He that descended in the same also that ascended up far above all heavens, that he might fill all things. And he gave some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers, for the perfecting of the saints, for the working of ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, that we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro, and carried about with every wind of doctrine, by the sleights of men and cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive, but speaking the truth in love, may grow up unto him in all things, which is the head, even Christ, from whom the whole body fitly joined together and compacted by that which every joint supplieth, according to the effectual working in the measure of every part, making increase of the body unto the edifying of itself in love. This I say therefore, and testify in the Lord, that ye henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk, in the vanity of their mind, having the understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that is in them, because of the blindness of their heart, who being past feeling have given themselves over unto lasciviousness, to walk all uncleanliness with greediness. But ye have not so learnt Christ. If so be that ye have heard him, and have been taught by him, as the truth is in Christ, that ye put off concerning the former conversation the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that ye put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Wherefore, putting away lying, speaking every man truth with his neighbor, for we are members one of another. Be angry and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath, neither give place to the devil. Let him that stole steal no more, but rather let him labor, working with his hands the things which is good, and he may have to give to him that needeth. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying, and it may minister grace unto the hearer. And grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby ye are sealed unto the day of redemption. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you, and all malice. And be kind one to another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake has forgiven you. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. This is the word of the Lord. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 1 to 32.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
There is power in his word.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. There is power in the name of Jesus. And today, if you do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, we want you to extend this invitation to you. It's an invitation that's extended to you by Jesus Christ of Nazareth, by God Almighty, your Father, by the blessed Holy Spirit. He's inviting you to come and sup with him. Come into the kingdom. Time is running out. Time is winding down. And your salvation, your eternity, is too precious to gamble with. Today, if you do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, now is the accepted time. He wants you to bring in you into the fullness of who he is. You know that Jesus Christ is Lord. You believe that, but you have not surrendered your life to him. You gave him and it's like you took it back. Amen? Because sometimes we say, okay, then yes, we believe. And we truly believe in our heart that Jesus Christ is Lord. For some who have had an understanding to their parents, to school, the education that they received, that there is a God and there's a Son of God, Jesus Christ, who died for their sins. And you must have gone through certain things on a spiritual level, on a religious level of knowing God. But God wants you to have a personal relationship with him. He wants you to know him as your Abba Father, the God who created you, the God who loves you, the God who is coming back for you, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, who went to Calvary, and he wants you to have a relationship with the Father through him. That's the relationship that is offered to you through salvation. Salvation is a free gift. He said, Whosoever call on the name of Jesus shall be saved. So you might say, well, I do not qualify because I've done so many things. I've done so many wrong. I did not live my life according to the principles of the gospel. I've hurt people. I have lied. I've cheated. I've killed. I've raped somebody. Whatever sin that he's holding you in the kingdom of darkness, that you feel in your spirit man, in your mind, that it's so big that God cannot forgive you. He's saying to you, come to the table, come to the water, and he would give you forgiveness. He would forgive you. All you have to do is trust him. Trust him at his word. He said he will never leave you nor forsake you. He said who the Son gave to the Father gave to him, he will not lose one. And God has given you to him, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And he doesn't want you to lose you. He doesn't want you to go into a Christless eternity. As we look around, signs of the times are everywhere. There are so many climate changes. We see the effects of the Hurricane Matthew as it went through Haiti, and you know, it went through the Carolinas, north and south. 36 people dead in just in the US. Hundreds, you know, are suffering in Haiti from the effects of the hurricane, cholera, and people are dying. Some know Christ, and they're going to see his face when he comes, because the dead in Christ shall rise, and those who are remain shall be caught up to meet him in the air. But those who do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior and were not prepared for eternity would be facing a Christless eternity. That's the reality of what is taking place. Amen. And you do not want to be caught in the number because of a natural disaster or something that would happen. You know, we reject it in the name of Jesus, that you will not be a victim to a calamity that will take you suddenly. That God, you will have you so prepared when you're ready to face him, that you know that you know that you know that eternity belongs to you. Amen. That you will have everlasting life. That every tear that you cry right now will be wiped away. God wants you to know tonight that all it takes to enter into rest with him is to acknowledge Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, to take his word. He said, who comes to God must believe that God is God, and he rewards those who diligently seek him. The fact that you tuned in this evening, it means that you are diligently seeking to find the truth of your existence. You want something more that you cannot give yourself. So you are seeking to find the God of your salvation, the God of your creation, who created you. Amen. The God who loves you. And because you have tuned in, he said, who comes to him must believe that he's God. And if we don't believe that God is God, then our faith and our hope is in nothing. We must know that we are not self-existent. We have been created by a mighty hand, a powerful creator who have given you life. Amen. He breathed life into us. We were just dust, and he breathed life. We see it in Genesis, in the book of Genesis chapter 1. We see how he created everything. The earth was void without form. Darkness was on the face of the deep. And he said, God spoke. He said, let there be light. And there was life. And the Spirit of the Lord breathed upon the face of the deep. God wants the Spirit to breathe upon you tonight. He wants you to come into his kingdom. He wants you to not have one foot outside and one foot inside. You believe that Jesus Christ is Lord, but you have not surrendered your all to him. You have not surrendered your life to him. He wants to be God. He wants to be king over all the thrones in your life. Amen. He wants you to not have part of your heart that you keep back for yourself. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs chapter 3, it's verse 3 to 5, he said, trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Don't lean onto your own understanding, which is your mind. In everything you do, acknowledge him. Everything you do, acknowledge God, and he will direct your path. Many times we direct our path. Many times we go our own way. Many times we form our reality. This is what we believe. This is what I think. This is what I am hoping to achieve. What does God want? What did God would say? We did not check to hear what the Master wants from our lives. There is a GPS system, which is the Word of God, the Bible, and it will lead you into eternity if you trust God at his word. He said his word will not return unto him void, but will accomplish what he has sent it out to do. He sent his word and it healed them all. Yes, Jesus Christ, God sent his word and it healed them all. Amen. So there is nothing. You might be sick tonight. You might have an infirmity, and we all go through some stress in our body that will bring something on at some time, because this body, sometimes it grow weary, old and sickly too. But that body only house you, the real you. Amen. That's your spirit man. And God wants to connect with that part of you, the spirit man, so that your body and your soul and everything will come in alignment with his word, and you will follow after his word and live not according to your way, but unto God's way. He wants you to be born again. He wants you to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Every message that you hear concerning the Word of God that connects to God is useless exercise if we do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Amen. You cannot know, you cannot enjoy the creature and not exalt the creator. Amen. We have to understand that with the things that's in the word of God, that you may take it and you may say, okay, then yes, I'm living a better life because of it. But are you born again? Did you give your life to Jesus Christ? Are you sure that your sins are forgiven? Is Jesus Christ the Lord of your life? Do you make your decision based on what God feels, and God, how would it affect him? Amen. God wants you to surrender all to him, all the thrones that you are holding on to. Sometimes we give God part of our heart. We give him maybe half or sometimes quarter, but we don't give him our whole heart. He wants us to trust him with all our hearts. We trust him with our finance, that he's going to prosper us. We trust him that we will be healthy, that he's going to take care of us, but we don't trust him with our eternal life. Amen. Because we have not made any preparation. We do not know where we're going to go if we face a Christless eternity. It will be on us, because Jesus Christ said in his word, he's the only way, he's the only truth, and he's the only life. We must be born again. He told Nicodemus, you must be born again. Paul was on a way of destruction. We see it in Acts chapter 9, and we're going to go into that scripture. He was killing Christians because he felt that what he doing was noble and right, and God had to arrest him and say, listen, I want you to stop. And sometimes God have to arrest us so that we can stop and think and say, wait a minute, you know, there's more to this thing called life. There's someone that is above me. I am not the author and the finisher of who I am. No, I begun my life because Jesus Christ, God Almighty, the Holy Spirit, made it possible for me to be here. God created you. God is love, and he loved you that he brought you to earth, but he brought you with a purpose, with a destiny. He brought you and he had a vision for you, and we have to fulfill the purpose of our lives before we leave this world. If not, when we stand before God, he's going to look at us and say, what have you done for me lately? What did you do for me while you were on earth? Amen. All that we do, it's good. All things are good, but not expedient. Sometimes we think that we're doing everything good because we are living a moral life. We are not sinning. We're not fornicating. We're not doing adultery. We're not killing. We're not stealing. We're not lying. And you think all is well. No. The word of God says you must be born again. Born of the Spirit of God and born of water through water baptism. You must be born again. When Jesus went into the Jordan River and he was baptized by John the Baptist, he was identifying that he wanted us to identify with that same baptism, that we are washed by his blood. We are washed in water. Amen. And he wants to wash all our sins away, because he went to Calvary, and all the way he went just to die for us. And so great a salvation he have left as a gift, but we must receive it. He wants to break every chain, because there's power in the name of Jesus. There's chains that are holding you in the kingdom of darkness. There's chains that are holding you so that you do not want to enter into rest with God, because you think it's okay. I got up this morning. Yes, but tomorrow is not promised to anyone. Tomorrow is not promised to no man. We are here today, but tomorrow we don't know. And God wants us to know that tomorrow is in his hand, and he wants to give you a better tomorrow. He wants that your tomorrow be in alignment with his word, which means that you must receive Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior. He said he came that the world to him might be saved. Amen. Whatever you have learned before concerning how to get to the Father, there is only one way, and it's through Jesus Christ. Accept him today as your Lord and Savior. Praise the name of the Lord.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Praise the name of the Lord. Do not walk in the vanity of your mind. You know, he said in the book of Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 17, Paul was saying here, he said, this I say therefore and testify in the Lord, that he therefore henceforth walk not as others Gentiles walk, in the vanity of their minds. You may say others are doing it. Others are not close. I see Christians and they seem to be okay with me because they are Christians, you know. They belong to this denomination or this denomination. But Paul is saying, this I say therefore and testify in the Lord, that he henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk, in the vanity of their minds. Many times people are walking in the vanity of their mind, in their own pride, in their own thinking, in their own behavior patterns. And this is what they're going to portray. This is what they're going to live by. But God wants you to walk in the word. He wants you to walk according to his principles, according to his precepts, according to his laws, according to what his judgments are. Amen. He does not want us to do our own thing. He wants us to know there is power in this word of God. As when you give your heart to Jesus Christ, all things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. Paul was a man who, when he was killing Christians, he was very passionate about what he believed. So he was upfront with what he was doing. He was killing like there is no tomorrow. But when he became transformed by the spirit was renewed, we see that now he became zealous for Christ. The same passion he had when he was a non-believer, he transmitted that same vigor, that same vitality, that same passion. He became so engrossed, so encapsulated with who Jesus was, and his salvation was so important to him that he became one of the mighty force behind this word in the New Testament, the epistles and all the books that he have written, so that we will know how to live. He became passionate about the Lord and Savior. We too have to become passionate about our God, about our salvation, for those who are saved. God wants us to stand and represent him wherever we go. If it's on the job, if it's in our neighborhood, if it's in our, you know, with our children, whatever it is, he wants us to have Christ-like characters. He does not want you to be like everyone. He wants you to be different. We are a peculiar people, a royal people, a chosen generation, and we're supposed to live that life, so that the Bible that somebody else would be reading would be your life. Amen. So God, those who are saved, who have given their life to Christ, we have to know that God wants us to live a life that is pleasing to him, and that we become change agent for his kingdom. He wants us to just be so in love with him that we would want to testify concerning who he is. Praise the name of the Lord. I hear the chains falling, yes. And tonight, if you do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, all the chains that hold you in the kingdom of darkness can fall off tonight. All you have to do is surrender your heart to Jesus Christ of Nazareth. All you have to do is say, yes, Jesus Christ is Lord. I put him first place in my life, and everything else that I have in my life, they are addition to my life. And I bless the Lord for giving me all those things that are added to my life. But the most important thing that I want is a relationship with the Almighty God through Jesus Christ of Nazareth. If the Holy Spirit is speaking to your spirit tonight, is you feeling a nudge telling you that yes, yes, this is me, give your heart to Jesus Christ tonight. Time is winding down. We are living in terrible times. Tonight, you may have an opportunity, but we don't know about tomorrow. Tomorrow is promised to no man. Give your heart to Jesus Christ tonight. He wants to save you. He wants to write your name in heaven. He said if all it takes is if you confess with your mouth, believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord, he come into your heart, you know, and he will live there. You will say, well, for somebody out there tonight to say that I have a problem, I cannot forgive, somebody have done me wrong and I cannot forgive, I'm having a problem forgiving and letting go of that one who have hurt me. Yes, I'm speaking to you who have unforgiveness because someone have hurt you. Many times we experience hurt from, most times it's from the people that we love most, that hurt we may bring hurt and pain to our lives, because the people who are close to you that sometimes are the ones who bring pain to you. But if you read the word of God and if you believe that this word is the word of God, it says we must forgive. In Matthew chapter 6 verse 15, he said, if you forgive not men their trespasses, then I would not forgive you. Amen. So Matthew 6:15 let us know that there's a condition. If we forgive men our trespasses, they will forgive us, then God will forgive us. But if we don't, God will not forgive us. Amen. And this is the word of the Lord. It is not my word. So many times in my experience of people hurting me as I went along my life, I have learned to let go and let God. Amen. Sometimes we just have to let go and say, God, I need my forgiveness. So I make a choice to forgive that person. He said in his word that you must forgive. Amen. It's a condition of the heart. Amen. You will know if you have forgiven someone because you will feel that forgiveness. You will know that you are at peace. There's a peace that comes with that forgiveness. It does not mean that the person didn't do you or something wrong. It does not mean that you didn't feel the pain of what they have done. But you make a choice to let it go and say, you know what? I am not going to keep this thing in my heart because I don't want it to form roots in my heart, and I don't want it to hinder me that God will not forgive me my own trespasses. He said, be kind to one another, forgiving each other, in Ephesians 4 verse 32. Praise the name of the Lord. If you have your Bibles, Ephesians 4, you could get to verse 32. It says, and be ye kind one to another, tender hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake has forgiven you. Even as God for Christ's sake has forgiven you. God has forgiven you for Christ's sake, because Christ died for you and he paid a price so that you can be forgiven. Even for God is as God for Christ's sake has forgiven you. So when we think about how God has forgiven us, it should make it a little easier for us to forgive. And sometimes it takes an effort. I'm not saying it's always easy. There have times when I struggled with unforgiveness, and I had to go to many times I had to go back and say, Lord, I make a choice to forgive that person, because sometimes the pain will come back and the pain will cause more pain and more pain, and then you're not sure if you forgive. So then it takes a time when you have to invite the Holy Spirit to help you. Lord, Holy Spirit, you are my helper, and you can summon help of the Holy Spirit if you're having difficulty to forgive someone. But you must remember that the quicker you forgive, the more grace is added to your life, the more mercy God gives to you. Amen. Remember, Philippians 4:13 said that we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. He says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Christ strengthens you through the power of the Holy Spirit. Christ strengthens you because guess what? We can draw on his strength, because he's always sitting at the right hand of the Father making intercessions for us. And whatever we think that we cannot do, he can give us the strength to forgive. Many times, you know, people stay outside of the kingdom because of unforgiveness. There's things that, because people have done them wrong, that God don't care about them anymore, that God don't love them anymore, that God don't love them at all. But this is not so. He said, in this life we'll have some tribulation, but be of good courage, we shall overcome the world. There's times when we have to understand that the things that get thrown out of on us, it's supposed to make us stronger. Amen. We're supposed to get stronger, not weaker. Praise the name of the Lord. If any man say, I love God and hate his brother, then something is wrong. 1 John 4:20 says this. Amen. And we have to make sure that we are forgiven as Christ has forgiven us. Amen. We were not perfect. God has not given us any one of us. There's only Christ that walk in perfection, but we strive to be like Jesus is. 1 John chapter 4, praise the name of the Lord, and verse 20. 1 John 4 and verse 20, praise the name of the Lord. It said, if any man say, I love God and hateth his brother, he is a liar. For he that loveth not his brother whom he has seen, how can he love God whom he has not seen? Many times we may feel that we hate this brother or we hate this sister. And yes, you can hate somebody silently. You don't have to come and say that you hate them. But, you know, your action shows that you don't love that person. Amen. Because love does not do evil to that other person. He said, if we say that we love that person, if a man say, I love God and hate his brother, he is a liar. He that love not his brother whom he has seen, how can he love God whom he have not seen? We have not seen God, but we say that we love him. So if we say that we love God that we didn't see, and we see in our brother that we see, then we have to love those that we can see, because God we cannot see, but there's no way we can love God that we don't see if the one that we see we don't love. Amen. So then the Bible is saying here that, you know, we become a liar. Amen. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, because fear has torment. He that feareth is not perfect in love. Yes, sometimes we don't want to, sometimes we hold on to things because someone we don't want to get hurt again because we fear. We do not want to love that way again. For somebody who might have lost a loved one or somebody who they care about and they do not even want to be in a relationship, much less to be in a relationship with God, the Father. God is one to say to you tonight that perfect love casts out fear. But the love that God wants to bestow upon you is not an eros love in terms of finding you a mate. Yes. He will have that for you, but he wants to first give you that agape love, which is the God kind love, the love that God is love. He wants to bestow that love upon you. He wants to break every chain that hold you in the kingdom of darkness. He wants you to know tonight that tonight, if you say yes, that you want him in your life, that he brings love, a love that you cannot get from any other human being. It's a love that sustains you. It's a love that envelops you. It's a love that surrounds you. It's a love that lives inside you. It's a love that is eternal. Amen. It's a God kind of love. He loves you in spite of your flaws, in spite of your mistakes, in spite of your bad habits. He loves you and he wants you to know tonight that yes, I have called you. I have chosen you. I know everything about you. I know every hair on your head. I know the thoughts I have towards you. They are not evil, but they are good, and to bring you to an expected end, a good end, according to Jeremiah 29 and verse 11. He wants you to surrender all to him tonight. Yes, you know about him. You have one foot in the kingdom and you have one foot in the world. He wants you to put your 2 feet in and said, yes, I am surrendering every throne in my life. I'm putting them down and I'm laying down every king in that's ruling my life. I want to be ruled by only one king, and it's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, God Almighty, the blessed Holy Spirit. And come into that one heart tonight. And Lord God, I ask that they will make you Lord and Savior. Shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, for that one who do not know you as Lord and Savior tonight, or they have known about you and they are not sure if their salvation is secure, I ask you, God, Father, Lord God, on tonight, to draw that one by the power of your Spirit, O God. I ask you, O God, that one said, yes, Jesus Christ is Lord. I do not want to miss heaven. I do not want to miss eternity. I know I have a lot of things that is not straight, but I love God, but I want to love him more. I want to give everything to him. I want him to be ruler of my life. Tonight, if you say this and you believe it in your heart that you want to make him Lord of everything in your life, tonight he will write your name in heaven, in the Lamb's book of life, and heaven shall be your portion. Hell shall never be your portion. And tonight, oh God, Father, Holy Spirit, I ask you to draw that one, forgive that one for every sin, every stain. Oh Lord, Father, Lord God, that they will know, oh God, Father, that you are forgiven every single thing that they have done from the time they came onto this earth until this very day, oh God, until this very evening, that you have forgiven them for all their sins, oh God. I ask you, oh God, by the power of the Holy Spirit, to give them the strength to let go, oh God, and let you, oh God, into their heart tonight, and that everything, every wrong, all those unforgiveness, oh God, that they cannot let go of, oh God, that tonight, oh God, Father, it dissolve and dissipate in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare, oh God, Father, as you have forgiven that one, that they, oh God, forgive all those who have trespassed against them. And Father, Lord God, don't lead them into temptation, but deliver that one from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. As that one decides, oh God, tonight, your child, oh God, make a decision that they would not, oh God, turn back, that they would not do the things they used to do, oh God, that they have, oh God, Father, Lord, a determination to just walk forward in you, in your word, and do things according to your word. They repent of their sin tonight, oh God, Father, and they said, yes, I want to do it God's way, not my way. I ask you, Father, Lord God, to have mercy and accept that one into your kingdom. I believe by faith that someone said, yes, Jesus Christ is Lord, and that name is written right now in heaven. Angels are rejoicing before the throne of grace because you said, yes, I accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. I believe by faith that I am saved. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. I hear them in the spirit. Praise the name of the Lord. I hear the chains falling. Thank you for the one who have let go of all those pains and hurt. And they make a choice to forgive as you have forgiven in them. And I say thank you, Father. Praise the name of the Lord. Another scripture reading from 1 John chapter 3, reading from verse 18 to 24. Praise the name of the Lord. It said, "My little children, let us not love in word, neither in tongue, but in deed, in truth. And hereby we know that we are of the truth, and shall assure our heart before him. For if our heart condemn us, God is greater than our heart, and knoweth all things. Beloved, if our heart condemn us not, then have we confidence towards God. And whatsoever we ask, we receive of him, because we keep his commandments and do those things which are pleasing in his sight. And this is his commandment, that we should believe on the name of his Son Jesus Christ, and love one another as he gave us commandment. And he that keepeth his commandments dwelleth in him, and he in him. And hereby we know that he abideth in us by the Spirit which he has given us." Praise the name of the Lord. As you give your heart this evening to Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit comes and live in us. Amen. We know that he abides in us by the Spirit which he has given us. You may not feel any way different, because salvation is not about a feeling, but it's about a faith that you believe that God has forgiven you. Amen. You must believe. Amen. And the Spirit of the Lord enters into your life and takes residence in your life. The Holy Spirit, which is the Spirit of the living God, has a new dwelling place in you, and all things are passed away. Behold, all things are new. I believe by faith that all things are new for you tonight. Jesus Christ is Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Jeremiah 29 verse 11. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We'll read from verse 11. It said, "For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, said the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end." Verse 12 said, "Then shall he call upon me, and you shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. And ye shall seek me and find me when ye have searched for me with all your heart." Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I say, read it again, Jeremiah 29, verse 11 to 13. He said, "For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, said the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil." Praise the name of the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil. Thoughts of peace and not of evil. To give you an expected end. Yes, he's speaking to you tonight. He wants to give you an expected end, which is a good end. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. He wants to give you a good end. Praise the name of the Lord. An expected end. Verse 11, verse 12 said, "Then shall he call upon me, and you shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you." Yes, you know, when you call upon the Lord tonight, yes, he wants you to talk to him. He wants you to call him, and he wants you to talk to him. Prayer is talking to our God, our Master, our Savior. Talk to God. We talk to our friends. We talk to our spouse. We talk to our children. But God wants you to talk to him. Amen. He wants you to tell him all about your troubles. Amen. Because there's some things that are bothering you. Now that you have given your life to Christ, he wants you to download on him now. He wants you to bring all those things that's in your spirit, man, in your head, in your emotions. He wants you to tell him about it. Amen. Because he has the answer to your situation. He said in verse 12, "They shall call upon me and he shall go and pray unto me and I will hearken unto you." He's saying to you tonight, "I will hear you." Now you have a relationship with him. You think that he was hearing you then when you did not have a relationship. Now he's going to really hearken unto you. He's going to be attentive to you even more because he already know the end from the beginning. He know tonight you'll hear this cry for salvation, that this word that will come to you tonight, and that you would surrender your life totally tonight, that you know that you know that you are saved. So he wants you to know that he, when you call upon him, he's going to, and you pray to him, you talk to him, he's going to hear you. Speak to the Lord, your master. He said, "And you shall seek me and find me." He said, "Who comes to God must believe that he's God," in the book of Hebrews. He said, "And he will reward those who diligently seek him." So he said, "Seek him and you will find me when you shall seek me with all your heart." Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. So when you seek him with all your heart. Amen. When you seek him with all your heart. He doesn't want you to seek him with some of your heart. He wants you to seek him with all of your heart. Sometimes I said in previously that sometimes we can give God some of our heart, some of our time, some of our everything. But he wants all of you. Amen. Jeremiah verse chapter 30. Praise the name of the Lord. If you have your Bibles, you can turn to Jeremiah chapter 30. And it shall, and verse 1, praise the name of the Lord. It said, "And it shall come to pass when all these things are come upon thee, and the blessing and the curses which I have set before thee, and thou shalt call them to mind among all the nations wherein the Lord thy God has driven thee." God says, you know, he's saying again that when we call upon him, you know, so we need to call upon him. Nations need to call upon him. We are in a terrible time, even in our nation, USA of America. We need to call upon the name of the Lord. The Bible says, "If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek his face, you know, turn from the wicked ways, then he will heal the land." Amen. We see so many trouble going on in this land today, and in political, socially, you know, economically, you know, and spiritually. God wants to heal our land, but we need to call upon him. We need to call upon him. Tonight, we're going to end right here because of time. And for that one who have said, "Yes, Jesus Christ is Lord," I say, thank you, Lord, for saving to the uttermost. In Jesus' name, amen. For that one who know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. He said he gave some apostles, some pastors, some evangelists, some teachers, some apostles, some prophets. And he said some, not everyone. But for every one of us, he have called us to make disciples of out of men. He has called us to be his servants. Amen. We are first a servant of the Most High God before we even have a title from the Most High God. We are his servants. We are his hands and feet on the world, in the world. The Bible says sheep begat sheep. He wants you to tell someone either Jesus Christ is Lord. He wants you to spread his name throughout the earth, wherever you go, that the name of the Lord will be lifted up. Amen. Tell somebody that Jesus Christ is Lord, or show them by your life that Jesus Christ is Lord over your life. Amen. You might be the Bible that that person is reading on the job. Make a difference. Make a difference as you walk along life's way. Praise the name of the Lord. Bring someone into the kingdom with you. Don't show up by yourself. Tell somebody that Jesus Christ is real and that he is the Savior, the only way, the only truth, and the only life. Praise the name of the Lord. We'll end there here now. And before we end, I would just want to say a prayer for those who have suffered loss, they have lost their loved ones in the hurricane, and those, you know, the hurricane is still, you know, not being, still going about, you know, doing, you know, the things that hurricane do, which is to destroy. But we're going to pray a short prayer that God will continue to heal and have mercy. Praise the name of the Lord. Father, Lord God, again, I lift those in Haiti, oh God. Oh God, who are suffering from cholera, from, oh God, all their belongings, all their security has been lost, their homes, oh God. I ask you, oh God, Father, Lord God, to, oh God, protect your people, oh God, wherever they may be, oh God. I ask you to watch over that land, oh God. Send the necessary helper, oh God, food, shelter, and clothing, and water, oh God, to those who have lost everything, oh God. I ask you to be merciful to your people, oh God. I ask you for those, oh God, who have lost, oh God, Father, oh God, in who have lost loved ones in the U.S., you know, in the Carolinas, oh God, North and South Carolina, oh God, those relatives who have lost their loved ones, that you will have mercy upon, oh God, Father, that place, oh God, that you will bring, oh God, that water, oh God, you will bring it down to oh God, the level that, oh God, it will not destroy, oh God, that, oh God, it will recede, oh God, in the name of Jesus, those whose homes are underwater, oh God, that but supernaturally touch, oh God, Father, you touch the waves, and you touch the flood, oh God, you touch the wave and the wind obey you, and you said peace be still. I ask you to touch your hands over those areas, oh God, and peace be still, oh God, still the water, oh God, that it will regress, oh God, in the name of, that it will dry up, oh God. You spoke to the fig tree and it dried up, oh God. So I ask you, oh God, to do it supernaturally in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I ask you, oh God, that your mercy be upon your people who are suffering through the effect of the hurricane. Comfort them at every side. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you from Choice Gospel Radio. Your life, your salvation, your choice. You have been listening to Salvation and Revelation. Have a blessed evening. Praise the name of the Lord. Pleasant good night to all.